Hello, hello everyone, Donna Gonzalez aquí. It is the middle of June and I would like to do a follow-up on the arugula harvest and how that looks. So in my hoop house, I just harvested the rest or the seed that I left. And so right behind me, I have the calita seed. And then right next to it on another tarp, I have the arugula seed. And so you can tell that both of them are super dried out. You can hear that they're like crunchy. There's absolutely no more moisture left inside these, and that's a good thing. And I let that happen kind of naturally all by itself, and that makes sure that the seed process is, you know, finished. There's going to be a wild germination rate for all these seeds, which is really good and which is what we want. So you want to wait for them to completely dry out. Next, I would show you the simplest way to preserve. And so you have a paper bag. I have labeled it arugula already. Arugula, month six. So 6/2020 and small hoop house, because that is where it came from. And all I will do is open up the bag and chuck my tiny seeds in here. So it's easy when I'm not on camera, but super easy. You can be as rough as you want. They're pretty like mature, and so you don't have to be gentle. Let me give you an example. You can quickly open up the pod and your small seeds come out. So that's exactly what you want. The seeds are pretty brown, reddish. They're really cute. So all you do is put all those small pods into your bag and you keep them in a dry area. Once you know that all the moisture is completely gone, approximately like in 2 more weeks, I would put all this seed into a glass container or a plastic container, just to make sure that no bugs can get to it. So there's a lot of different bugs that like to eat seeds, but of course, I think it's a worm weevil. So the worm weevils always find their way into seeds. And then the calitas are also super dry, so you can check how easily they just kind of crack and fall apart. So these babies easily fall off, and they are also easily visible, and that's exactly what you want. So you would also just chuck them off into a paper bag and make sure to label. Labeling is probably the hardest and the easiest, but do it because it's really good seed keeping and seed saving. And then next, I just want to cover that I have the garlic patch, and I just want to give y'all a really cool update on how it's looking. So this is the garlic all through here. Check it. Right now, all our garlics are getting their scapes. And so it's this cool curly baby right here. And I think it's only like hardneck that gets scapes. I could be wrong. But the hardneck is getting its curlies and scaping. And so when that happens, I actually like to pull them off. So I would pull the scape off. It's actually pretty easy. Check it out. I'll give you another example. And you actually want to pull from the base. So sorry, that was a bad example. But pull from the base and then you kind of have something longer. So garlic scapes are super delicious. You can eat them and use them pretty much just like garlic. Throw them in salsas, soups, stir fries, whatever you like garlic in. My mom actually made some really bomb salsa and like a homemade crema. That was really dope this week. And I can totally hook you guys up with the recipe if that's interesting. But so the scapes, let me give you some cool knowledge on the scapes. So I like to pull the scapes off because it will give the energy to the bulb and to the garlic. So if the energy is going to the bulb and the garlic, it gets bigger. It will fatten up and be probably You know, a third as big as it wouldn't be if you didn't yank it off. So that's pretty cool. Pretty cool fun fact. And then I know some farmers that actually like to leave them, and it makes the drying or hanging of the garlic easier. So I guess it depends on who you are as a farmer or what you're looking for. I'm looking for some bigger cloves, and I'm not worried necessarily about drying. So I'm still taking these babies off and munching them out, munching on them whenever I get the chance. But you can sell them at market. They're super profitable. Sell them at market. You can do a small bunch of scapes and yeah, make a little bit of money off of them. Yeah, I guess that's all I have to share today. So, middle of June. What's up? Hope everybody's doing well. Arugula and kalita seed and some garlic scape talk. I hope y'all have a wonderful evening. Peace out.